Hi everybody, this is Tom Cherry Holmes with Errata Online, and I wanted to give a quick demonstration of the latest alpha release of PLATOTerm running on actual hardware. But you can see right here that we have a Commodore 64C with a reproduction EPYX fastload cartridge. An SD2IEC device providing the disk drive, a Commodore Forever Wi-Fi modem, which is based on Paul Rickard's firmware, and just a pretty run-of-the-mill setup, what I expect mostly to be able to be used with this particular setup here. So with that, let's go ahead and bounce into our terminal here. I'll fire up the loader, and go down to terminals. I have right here a copy of CCGMS, but I have the latest build for PLATOTerm right here. Go ahead, and one of the nice things that you'll see on the distribution disk is, in addition to PLATOTerm, you actually have a runnable copy of the GPL 3.0 license on here on the disk as well. You also have all the needed drivers for your mouse and serial devices ready to go. As you can see right here, for serial devices, we support SwiftLink 232 devices, as well as user port-based modems running at 2400 bits per second. I hope to be adding UP9600 support soon enough. So with that, we'll go ahead and load PLATOTerm here. And within a few moments, we will have our PLATOTerm splash screen here. Here we go, all good. And at this particular point, we can either hit F3 to set up. I've already got all the setup parameters in place here, so all I need to do at this point is simply dial out. Since I'm using a Commodore Forever modem here, I go ahead and press Enter to enable my modem and to wake it up. And dial into Errata here. Now, I'm glad that hardware handshaking is actually functioning here, because now I don't have to run a slowdown server. And we'll see here. We connect, we get the negotiation, the initial banner from the control data machine, and we come right into Plato. And this is performance happening at 2400 bits per second right now. As you can see, not bad. So go ahead and log in with our test account here. You can also log in, as you can see right there, using guest and guest. Yes, I know. So, yeah. As we can see right here, all doing well. And we have access to our stuff here. And I'll go ahead, just to demonstrate the point here, we'll go ahead and go into air fight real quick. It downloads the character set in, which I still need to implement. Now that flow control is mostly out of the way, I can take and concentrate on that. We'll go ahead and move the mouse out of the way here. Go ahead, enter air fight. Go into circle squadron. And I'll go ahead and pick F-16 here. Ready to go. Name myself, and I'll say 5,000 pounds of fuel is fine, and yeah, X number of missiles. That's cool. And as we can see, yeah, here we are, going just fine. I won't take and do a flyby because I've done that in other demos here, but as you can see, it seems to be running just fine. And some of the other bits and pieces that were problematic before, particularly the password dialog and the first page of the notes menu, have now been pretty much worked around. But I mean, as you can see, just doing extremely well here. Going to notes. And the notes menu now shows up as expected. So we'll go ahead and go into, not announce, but let's see, go into public notes. And I'll go ahead and read the first message in the notes file. So, I mean, there you go. A copy of PLATOTerm Alpha running on actual hardware. Hope you guys have enjoyed this. More to come. See you guys later.